How do you think your last conversation ever will go? Will it be an apology? A thank you? Perhaps it's an inquiry. Letter from a pyre is what we leave unsaid and what we leave behind. Here is the story of a mother and a son. Thank you.
Sorry, Mom. I had some of the leftovers when I got home. They were still delicious.
It's okay. Just text me next time. And I was up late anyway, marking the attendance papers. 2 hours in a day.
Yeah, we'll do more.
And this silly goodbye party? As if we didn't have enough to do since Marcus left you. Just when I wonder if I'll be the only one left to find out the lights at the science department.
Focus on the party, not the goodbye. Those can be difficult. Really difficult. Anyway, are you still undecided for the present?
Maybe I should just bake a cake.
What's that supposed to mean? You're undefeated in the kitchen. She knows it. Remember that baklava you made for the Christmas party? How fast I got scooped up.
Well, it's nothing really. She's not really a snob. It's too bad since her husband's passed. She's been inconsolable. She must be so alone in that big house with no one else there now. You never know what somebody else could be going through after.
I've been thinking.
About Janet?
I'm sure she'll love whatever you make. I'm feeling tired. Here we're every day close at the mass. To the point I can't tell them. Anyway, I've been thinking of going away for a little while.
Oh, all of a sudden? Why didn't you tell me you were feeling tired? Where should we go?
Somewhere quiet. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't. Sorry, Mum. Is it the right time? No, forget it.
No,
Mum, I'm sorry for coming home so late.
It's okay. I told you I'd be up late anyway. Is everything alright, honey? You told me something was wrong, right? Sometimes I miss when you were little. You know, when we first got here, you barely spoke a word of English, yet you were so brave. You'd go to school every day with a big smile on your face and come back jumping up and down with excitement. You'd sit at this table and tell me everything that happened. You talk, telling me everything I know. I wish you could have said. And then you grew up, and you can finally say all the things in your head, either way. And yet you tell me nothing. I wish I could remind you of that day after school. You had to show me your notebook. And you had to write about your best friend. And you had. And it was me. And I was so happy. Those days so long gone now.
You're doing good though. All right, Mom.
Of course, I'm good. I'm good as long as you want.
Then I'm good too. It's just. Never mind. Don't worry about me, Mom. Actually,
go on, honey.
What do you say to a woman who is gone? Who's already gone? And I hold a knife in my hand. How do you apologize for a life taken? Who do you apologize to? I think I'm gonna go.
Have you decided where you're going to go?
Promise me you won't miss me too much.
I already miss you! I miss seeing you drink straight from the orange juice carton in the morning. I miss hearing you sing in the shower. And I miss the tune out playing of the radio and waiting to hear you knock on the front door. Just.
You wouldn't have to read this. I'm sorry you are. I'm sorry for so many things. I'm sorry I wasn't as strong as you were. Every night, I tore off your flesh to make this heaven, a world of home for me. I'm sorry I couldn't hold out for you when you needed me. I tried for so long. You were the only reason I've been here. The fear of hearing your screams to my broken, muted ears, the frantic calls, the restless nights, the tears. I wanted to save you from all of it. But this is the only letter I will write, because it isn't my apology. It's my gratitude. Thank you. In case you didn't hear it from my own lips, here it is. It's forever. Thank you, Mom. In this mean world, I hate every step I took. The cliffs that fall behind me with every move I made. Thank you for dealing with me without complaint. Without fear. Thank you for never telling me no without reason. giving me life. I'm so sorry I couldn't make it mine. Please don't blame yourself. Don't look back at the what ifs, the maybes. I don't know what, where I went wrong. Why it turned out like this, I don't know. But you were the one good thing. So move on. Read this letter and move on. Please. Thank you. Sorry. And goodbye.
Thank you so much. This is a letter from a pilot.